I declare open a convocation for the conferment of honorary doctorates, the presentation of high degree graduates and graduates of the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Public Policy and Global Affairs.
Professor Bertil Anderson, President of NTU, will now give his convocation address.
Chancellor, Nanyang Technological University, His Excellency President Tony Tan Ken Yam. Minister of Education, Higher Education and Skills, Mr. Ong Yi Kung. Pro-Chancellors, Chairman, NTU Board of Trustees, Mr. Koh Bon Wee. Members, NTU Board of Trustees, Excellencies, President Emeritus, Honorary Doctorate Recipients, Distinguished Guests, Graduate and Families, Alumni and Friends of the University, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Quite good. Yeah. Good morning, everyone, and a warm welcome to Nanyang Technological University's convocation 2017. Today is a day of celebration. Celebration of individual achievements of all the graduates, but also celebration of NTU, I think. Yes. The annual convocation is indeed a highlight of the university's annual calendar. So to all graduates, I congratulate you on your achievement. You have received a worthy goal, and today is sort of the first day in the rest of your life. And this morning, the people who supported you along the way, your parents, loved ones, faculty members and staff of the university, are here to celebrate with you. Actually, I think all your dedicated supporters also should be celebrated this morning. I think they deserve an applause as well. Why? Good. So, over the next 7 days, as many as 9,595 graduates will receive their degree scrolls during 19 ceremonies. I think that is impressive numbers. For me personally, this is a special convocation. I've been standing here 11 times before, because this will also be my last convocation as president of NTU. I have had the privilege to spend over 10 years in Singapore and NTU, a very rewarding time, I would say. It has given me the opportunity to contribute to NTU's rapid progress, together with the university's management, faculty and staff, as well as alumni. In addition, the Board of Trustees, Chancellors, Pro-Chancellors, government bodies, not the least the Ministry of Education, as well as other stakeholders from the private and public sectors, have been played very crucial role and been valued partners. And on top of that, I have been able to interact with many, many students and student leaders through the years. Students that any university president in the world would envy to have. Now, third time, applaud for our students. Whoa. This morning, we also have two highly distinguished graduates who will confer honorary doctorates. They are Professor James Barber and Professor Helga Novotny. Professor Barber is the Unchained Professor Emeritus of Biochemistry at Imperial College London. He will be conferred an honorary degree of Doctor of Science, honoris causa. This is in recognition of his exceptional and outstanding contributions to photosynthesis research and setting up the Solar Fuels Laboratory here at NTU. Professor Helga Novotny is Professor Emerita of Social Studies of Science at ETH in Zurich and the former President of the European Research Council. Professor Novotny is one of the most influential social scientists in Europe and an indefatigable champion of interdisciplinary research. She has, in a significant way, contributed to the development of NTU's College of Humanities, Art and Social Science, and to social science in general in Singapore. Singapore, as we know, is a young nation, and Nanyang Technological University, also a young university. Only last year, NTU celebrated its silver jubilee, meaning that we today can celebrate our 26 years in existence, meaning half the time of Singapore, because Singapore is the coming week celebrating 52 years. Today, NTU is firmly established as a world-class university, and its global reputation attracts world-acclaimed professors, researchers, and scholars, as well as top-level national and international students. A lot of universities, as well as industry and business, want to have NTU as a partner when it comes to education, research, as well as innovation. I may be a little bit modest now and remind you, and we have seen in the press that we were ranked by the QS in London as number 11 university in the world, the highest ranking any Asian university ever have reached. And for the fourth consecutive years, we are number one young university in the world. Our engineering is number four. That is also not too bad.
Yes, you agree.
Yeah. So, of course, one should take league tables with a pinch of salt, and also various rankings give various results, understandably. But I think it's safe to say that NTU's increased reputation also had added value to the NTU degrees for this year's graduate, as well as for previous degrees given to our alumni. And I think that is actually a very pleasing fact. But the coin have two sides. The increased reputation will facilitate you getting a good job, but the reputation will also increase the employer's expectations. It goes hand in hand. But noticeably though, the top level ranking for NTU I just mentioned was to a significant degree due to an increased satisfaction of employers who had experience from NTU students. So that's a good sign. Research has in recent years been more prevalent in Singapore and NTU. But it's important to stress, education remains a key mission for our university. But just like research is in constant development, so is education, as a reflection of changing society and technologies. New learning paradigm and technology also change not only what to learn, but how to learn. Employers want our graduates to have 21st century skills, and it's not only to have a disciplinary competence, important but not sufficient. Other things relate to character, creativity, civic-mindedness, and communication skills. We talk about the five C's for a complete education. The iconic building, the Hive, I guess you've seen it, is today really a symbol for NTU's modern education approach, including flipped classrooms and team-based learning, and also involving residential learning. Importantly, NTU is also approaching new groups in the Singapore society in its dedicated efforts when it comes to continuous education. No one, also in your cohort, can no longer rely on one single education during a lifetime. But there will be a need to top up new knowledge and even go into new areas which we don't even know what they are today. So dynamic is the future. So that is a crucial fundament of 21st century learning, and NTU is leading the way through its new college pace. The NTU campus has, since the last convocation, undergone significant developments. Many new student facilities, new learning places, shops and canteens, plus, of course, many more student dorms. Today, NTU campus can host almost 17 students on campus. And that is a very, very high number by international standards. The new big sports hall, The Wave, promises to be a new icon building on campus, and it is the biggest wooden building in Singapore. You must see it. The new clinical science building at Novena for our new medical school is impressive. It's the biggest academic building in Singapore, and it will provide top-level and modern clinical training facilities for the medical students. As I already mentioned, NTU has significantly developed its research in the last decade. That has been crucially supported by the National Research Foundation, NRF, and that has been instrumental for Singapore's quantum leap on the international scientific scene. NTU's research portfolio today is very broad, ranging from humanities, business, to engineering. From pure to applied research, and you need both. The latter involves many collaborations with national as well as international companies. Furthermore, it's in our new medical school at NTU, NTU is getting more and more into research related to medicine and healthcare, such as diabetes, genomics, but also issues around the aging society. NTU is today also making dedicated efforts to turn research investments into innovation and creation of startup companies. For example, to mention the collaboration of NTU with Israeli universities, private companies, and the city of Haifa, will immerse Singapore students in the entrepreneurial culture of the startup nation and also provide many research projects with highly strategic relevance within the innovation space. I should also here mention the engagement in Guangzhou in China, where NTU together with other Singaporean and Chinese stakeholders develop a strong innovation hub. NTU will this year also be responsible for the Wealth Management Institute. This will allow a synergistic collaboration in education and research between NTU and the crucial Singaporean finance industry. A project where NTU indeed, from its academic standpoint, aims directly to contribute to the Singapore economy. Let me end my speech here this morning by touching on our alumni. I said earlier, for the graduates, it's the first day in the rest of your life. But it's also the first day as real alumni. I hope, of course, you want to be very active alumni and come here quite often. You will join over 220,000 alumni from over 160 nationalities. That's a network. The vast majority of them come, of course, from Singapore, around 80%. Notably, a good portion of our alumni comes from NTU's precursor institutions, Nanyang University and NTI, thereby providing an important platform for promoting our university's legacy back in time. Through the newly formed NTU Alumni Council, the activities will be better aligned to various alumni priorities and needs. Alumni should support the university, that's what we hope, but the university should also support their alumni. And the third thing is that alumni should support alumni. And therefore, we have now created three alumni houses in Singapore. One down at Marina Square, down in the city, one at One North, and one here at our beautiful campus. And the ambition with these houses is, of course, that these alumni, you guys, should have useful and attractive interaction platforms for your activities. In closing, I want to express my appreciations to everyone who has contributed to the significant and successful development of NTU. The Chancellor, the Education Ministry, our Pro-Chancellors, the NTU Chairman and Board of Trustees, the NTU Management, and not the least to our dedicated professors, faculty and staff, and of course, our wonderful students, and in particular, the graduating students. Once again, my heartiest congratulations to the class of 2017. Now is the best time to cultivate your curiosity and follow your dreams. Yes, and dreams should come true. So let your NTU star shine and good things will follow. To have a degree from a top level university is the best ticket for a fruitful and successful career journey. Thank you very much and good luck.
An honorary doctorate is one of higher education's most significant accolades. The university awards honorary doctorates to distinguished individuals who have achieved preeminence in their field or profession, or who have made significant contributions to their country, society, or in international relations. They are conferred on individuals who have rendered distinguished service to the university or the community in the advancement of learning and knowledge, or who have contributed significantly to the development of their country or the betterment of society and international relations. This year, two distinguished individuals have been awarded, and they are Professor James Barber, FRS, Ernst Chain Professor of Biochemistry Emeritus, Imperial College London, and Professor Helga Nowotny, Professor Emerita of Science and Technology Studies, ETH Zurich, Chair, ERA Council Forum Austria, former President, European Research Council. Professor Bertel Anderson, public orator, will deliver his citation in respect of Professor James Barber.
May I invite Professor James Barber to rise to acknowledge the citation and acclaim of this convocation, please. Professor Barber is currently the Ernst Chain Emeritus Professor of Biochemistry in Imperial College London. He is also a Fellow of the Royal Society in London. Professor Barber has been elected member of the European Academy and a foreign member of the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences. He was Dean of the Royal College of Science at Imperial College London and headed the biochemistry department for a decade from 1989 to 1999. Professor Barber was appointed at NTU School of Material Science and Engineering as a canon visiting professor in December 2012. But has been actively engaged with NTU since 2008. Professor Barber received a Bachelor of Science degree from University of College in Swansea in 1964, and both a Master of Science and Doctor of Philosophy from University of East Anglia in 1965 and 67, respectively. Professor Barber joined Imperial College in 1968 and was promoted to full professor in 1979. Professor Barber is a world-renowned scientist, and his research focus has been to investigate photosynthesis and the role of photosystems with an emphasis on their structure and function. He has published over 650 original papers and reviews and have a total citation of about 22,000. Much of the work is focused on Food System 2. And you can say it's a biological machine in green leaves and algae. And it is able to use light energy, solar light energy, to split water into oxygen, gas, and reducing equivalent. This water splitting process is the fundamental energy storage process on our planet, and it also maintains the global carbon and oxygen balance necessary for life on Earth. In recent years, Professor Barber has used X-ray diffraction analysis on crystals of Food System 2 to reveal the atomic structure of the vital water splitting system. Using insights from these heroic studies, Professor Barber has elucidated the likely mechanism for energy storage in nature photosynthesis, and that has become a blueprint for subsequent, more applied research to create artificial photosynthesis, or artificial leaves, we can say. The ambition is to mimic nature's energy system in order to create a sustainable energy system for a modern society. A crucial task, indeed, we all can realize. Professor Barber has strongly championed the concept of artificial photosynthesis, and his simple rhetoric has been, if plants can do it, we can do it. After all, it's only chemistry. Maybe the only is a little bit of pushing it. Since joining NTU 8 years ago, as a visiting professor, he has been instrumental in setting up the Solar Fuels Laboratory at NTU, which was the first in Asia. As scientific advisor of the Solar Fuels Laboratory, Professor Barber has been in the bedrock of success for the research, driving the laboratory to achieve both frontline science and translatable engineering in the field of solar fuels. He was also, we should remind ourselves, invited to Singapore in 28 as the Lee Kuan Yew Distinguished Visitor. Professor Barber's achievements and contributions have been recognized globally. He received the prestigious Flintoff Medal by the Royal Society of Chemistry in 2002, the Industry Ital Gas Prize for Energy and Environment in 2005, the Biochemical Society Novartis Medal and Prize in 2006, and the Wieland Medal and Prize from the University of Chicago in 2007. Professor Barber was also awarded the prestigious Interdisciplinary Prize and Medal by the Royal Society of Chemistry in 2013, and in 2016, he received the George Porter Medal, an international award for outstanding contributions to photochemistry and its applications. Professor Barber truly deserves this honorary degree for his exceptional achievements in the field of photosynthesis and for his role in starting and nurturing the study of artificial photosynthesis NTU. Mr. Chancellor, it's my honor and privilege to present to you Professor James Barber for the award of honorary degree of Doctor of Sciences.
Professor Bertil Anderson, President of NTU, will put the degree hood on Professor James Barber. Mr. Chancellor, may it please you to confer upon Professor James Barber the honorary degree of Doctor of Science.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I confer upon Professor James Barber the honorary degree of Doctor of Science.
Professor Alan Chan, public orator, will deliver his citation in respect of Professor Helga Nowotny.
May I please invite Professor Helga Nowotny to rise to acknowledge the citation and acclaim of this convocation. Professor Helga Nowotny, as you have already heard, is Professor Emerita of Science and Technology Studies at ETH Zurich and a founding member and former president of the European Research Council, or ERC. Now, the establishment of the ERC was a major breakthrough in Europe, which transformed the European research landscape, attracted international talent, and helped shape the development of a new knowledge-based economy throughout the European Union. Currently, Professor Nowotny is chair of the European Research Council Area Council Forum Austria, which is an expert panel advising the Austrian minister responsible for science and research. She is also vice president of the Council for the Lindau Nobel Laureate Meetings and University Council member of the Ludwig Maximilians University in Munich, among many other appointments. Professor Nowotny has been Nanyang Visiting Professor at NTU since 2016, and in that capacity contributed significantly to the university. Professor Nowotny received her PhD in sociology from Columbia University in New York, following a doctorate in jurisprudence from the University of Vienna. She has held teaching and research positions at a number of institutions, including the University of Vienna, Cambridge University, and the Center for Social Science Research in Berlin, among many others. Professor Nowotny is a member, as a foreign member, of the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences and several other academies as well. She has served and continues to serve on many international advisory boards throughout Europe, and she is the recipient of numerous awards, including 7 honorary doctorates, the most recent of which was conferred by the University of Edinburgh. Throughout her distinguished career, Professor Nowotny has been at the forefront of science and innovation policy matters. A prolific scholar at the same time, Professor Nowotny has published widely, especially in Science and Technology Studies, or STS, and on the changing conceptions of time in social contexts. Her latest book, Eigenzeit Revisited, came out in 2016, and her 2015 book, The Cunning of Uncertainty, as it is titled, has been widely reviewed and featured by the Financial Times on the list of the best books of 2015. The Straits Times of Singapore referred to it as a book that contains, and I quote, a big well of wisdom, a book that promises to refresh our sense of wonder if we take the time to drink deep from it. A strong advocate of interdisciplinary research, Professor Nowotny has been actively involved in the development of social science and complexity science at NTU. In fact, her association with the university started long before she was appointed Nanyang Visiting Professor, in as early as 2008. The global challenges that the world faces cannot be resolved without a committed and concerted effort bringing together the natural sciences, social sciences, and humanities. And this has been Professor Novotny's clarion call to the scientific community, broadly defined in the older European sense of Wissenschaft. As NTU developed into a standard-setting community of interdisciplinary learning and research, we turned to Professor Novotny for guidance, not only in developing social science, but also, and I think more importantly, overcoming disciplinary divides and channeling our creative energy to better understand the processes of knowledge creation, the knowledge production, and the ways in which technology brings about social change. Professor Novotny not only has contributed in many important ways to research and innovation at NTU, but also her advice is much sought after by policymakers in Singapore. Always generous with her time, she has provided much appreciated input to enhancing Singapore's growing research landscape, especially on the optimal structure and funding strategy of research councils, and also the contribution of the social sciences and humanities to economic and social development. Over a long and truly distinguished career, Professor Novotny has been a powerful voice, a powerful force in setting global research agendas and upholding exact standards of research integrity. And she has worked tirelessly in defending and promoting diversity in academia and equal opportunities for women in research. Principled and dynamic, Professor Novotny stands out as an exceptional role model and mentor for young scholars. Professor Helga Novotny is one of the most influential social scientists in Europe and truly deserves this recognition for her outstanding achievements in scholarship and public service and for her contributions to the university. Mr. Chancellor, it is my honor and privilege to present to you Professor Helga Novotny for the award of the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters.
Professor Bertel Anderson, President of NTU, will put the degree hood on Professor Helga Novotny. Mr. Chancellor, may it please you to confer upon Professor Helga Novotny the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I confer upon Professor Helga Novotny the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters.
Mr. Chancellor, may I present the following graduates on whom the Doctor of Philosophy has been earlier conferred. Chen Nahui. Espinar Darlene Macau de Leon. Kadik Rati Dwi Oktarini. Nguyen Thai Han Quen. Sun Ching Dren. Chen Lucy. Chu Yuan Ga Pony. Chua Hui Chin. Edward Hallin. Huang Zichun. Islam Nazru. Li Xiao Lu. Luo Cheng Wen. Nagpal Tanya. Ao Kun. Shang Nan. Tan Wei Yi, Amanda. Yu Ling. In Di. That's all? Okay.
The Renaissance Engineering Program is a premier scholars program that aims to nurture students as future leaders of industry. The students are provided with a broad-based interdisciplinary engineering education, which also includes a one-year overseas experience studying in a renowned partner university. This unique curriculum is designed to nurture engineering leaders with an entrepreneurial spirit to serve society with integrity and excellence. This program is characterized by the awarding of a Bachelor of Engineering Science coupled with a Master of Science in Technology Management. Mr. Chancellor, may I present the following graduates on whom the degrees of Bachelor of Engineering Science and Master of Science in Technology Management have earlier been conferred. Winner of the Lee Kuan Yew Gold Medal, Yong Yong Chow Tommy. Winner of the Koh Boon Hui Scholars Award, T. T-May-E. Winner of the Keppel Gold Medal, Mi Mu Sin. USP Scholar, Brian So Wei Da. USP Scholar, Neil Shen Hao Edwin. USP Scholar, Tan Shu Ting Jermaine. USP Course Scholar, Zheng Kaixi. Aditya Sunil Nakru. Ang Guo Hao Jovian. Angjan Danny. Chen Wei Yan. Chu Jia Rong. Chao Shi Lin Clarice. Chong Shi Hui Karina. Gosh Soham. Guo Wen. Harita Murali Dharan. Ho Jia Jun. Kek Chen Yun. Ko Sin E. Sebastian. Kundu Srijit. Lam Shao Ying. Lee Se Chi. Li Yuan Ming. Leong Shi Yuan Leonard. Leong Yu Rong. Li Xie Na. Lim Jia Min. Matthew James. Ng Ping Yuan Joan. Nguyen Thi Hoi Tan. Niu Yen Ling. Nor Shazana Putri Asmuni. Nguyen Nguyen Lin Wu. Sean Go Jian Hui. Sing Hui Min Kevin. Serene Ng. Sing Jin An. Tan Kok Leong Leon. Tae Jin Yang Justin. Teo Zhe Chien Theodore. Teo Zhi Kai Daryl. Dei Hui Jie. Do Rei Jie. Wang Shen Ya. Wang Yi Ru. Wang Yuebin Daniel. Wang Ji In. Wang Ki En. Wu Yi Jia. Xi Sun Tao. Yap Tek Lin. Zhou Yi Tian.
Bearing utmost prominence by virtue of the name of the award, the Lee Kuan Yew Gold Medals are awarded in recognition of academic excellence. This year, the gold medals will be awarded to 34 top NTU students who are first in general proficiency throughout their respective programs of study and who have obtained a first-class honors degree. Mr. Chancellor, may I present the following graduates who have been awarded the Lee Kuan Yew Gold Medals. Aaron Lim Han Meng, Bachelor of Science Education. Chan Pei Lin, Bachelor of Arts in Economics. Chandra Bhavya, Bachelor of Engineering, Computer Engineering. Chuck Yen Hui, Bachelor of Arts Education. Erickson Chua, Bachelor of Science in Physics. Guo Qing Yao, Bachelor of Engineering, Environmental Engineering. Hong Yi Chun, Bachelor of Arts in English. Huang Sheng, Bachelor of Engineering, Mechanical Engineering. Ian Russell Ko Tsu Ming, Bachelor of Arts in Sociology. John Tang Fu Sheng, Bachelor of Science, Sports Science and Management. Li Pei Shi, Bachelor of Science in Biological Sciences. Li Hong Tse, Bachelor of Engineering, Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Lim Tia Hao, Bachelor of Accountancy. Lin Ro Ting, Bachelor of Arts in Chinese. Lo Singing Alexandra, double degree in Bachelor of Accountancy and Bachelor of Business, awarded for Bachelor of Business. Lo Chang Chuen, Bachelor of Communication Studies. Lo Shi Jun, Bachelor of Science, Maritime Studies. Miao Ling Yi, Bachelor of Engineering, Civil. Mohammad Shafiq bin Mohammad Yusuf, Bachelor of Science in Chemistry and Biological Chemistry. Ngo Chien Hao, Bachelor of Arts in History. Nguyen Balong, Bachelor of Engineering, Bioengineering. Nguyen Fan Hui, Bachelor of Engineering, Computer Science. Pang Chi Hui, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Pang Yinpeng Selwyn, Bachelor of Engineering, Aerospace Engineering. Pitt Waitzer, Bachelor of Arts in Public Policy and Global Affairs. Tin Tin, Bachelor of Science in Mathematics and Economics. Tan Wan Yen, Bachelor of Science in Biomedical Sciences, NTU Beijing University of Chinese Medicine Double Degree Program, awarded for Bachelor of Science in Biomedical Sciences. Tan Yao Yang Brian, Bachelor of Fine Arts in Product Design. To Chao Chi, Bachelor of Science in Mathematical Sciences. Xie Wenhan, Bachelor of Arts in Linguistics and Multilingual Studies. Yongyong Chow Tommy, Bachelor of Engineering Science and Master of Science in Technology Management, awarded for Bachelor of Engineering Science. Cheng Qiming, Bachelor of Engineering, Information Engineering and Media. Cheng Qiming, my apologies. To Yun Chi, Bachelor of Engineering, Chemical and Biomolecular Engineering. The Kobun Wee Scholars Award recognizes the influence of inspirational teaching and the enduring bonds that are forged between teachers and students. The award will be presented to 12 top NTU students who have achieved excellent academic performance, displayed strong leadership ability, demonstrated potential for contributing to society, as well as displayed exemplary conduct and been held as role models for their peers. Each award winner will honor an NTU faculty member and a teacher from his or her former junior college, polytechnic, or an equivalent institution. Each teacher so honored will have a $5,000 cash grant established in his or her name. The teacher will nominate a student from his or her junior college, polytechnic, or equivalent institution to receive the $5,000 grant upon the student's admission to NTU. Mr. Chancellor, may I present the following winners, their teachers, and NTU faculty members to be honored. Cheng Lei Hong, Bachelor of Science in Biological Sciences. Wishes to honor Dr. Chang Peng Chi from Temasek Polytechnic. And Assistant Professor Oliver Muller Keha. Xia Min, Bachelor of Arts in English. Wishes to honor Mr. Eugene Yao, Catholic Junior College. And Assistant Professor Graham John Matthews from the School of Humanities. Go Cheng Yao, Bachelor of Engineering, Environmental Engineering. Wishes to honor Mr. Lim Teng from Serangoon Junior College. And Dr. Ho Shen Yong from the School of Physical and Mathematical Sciences. Jefferson, Bachelor of Engineering, Mechanical Engineering. Wishes to honor Assistant Professor Marcos from the School of Mechanical and Aerospace Engineering. Joel Lee Tun Tse, Bachelor of Accountancy. Wishes to honor Ms. Tan Yen Yen from Singapore Polytechnic. And Dr. Ko Cheng Boon from the Nanyang Business School. Kan Tang Tang Delia, Bachelor of Science in Biological Sciences. Wishes to honor Ms. Ma Chia Lin from Raffles Institution. And Associate Professor Poon Kin Long Kenneth from National Institute of Education. Leong Yao Yek Aldrea, Bachelor of Science, Sports Science and Management. Wishes to honor Ms. Elaine Wong from Raffles Institution. And Associate Professor Burns Stephen Francis from the National Institute of Education. Mahara Binti Abdul Mahid, Bachelor of Science in Biological Sciences. Wishes to honor Ms. Siti Norbaya Ramli from Republic Polytechnic. And Assistant Professor Wu Wei Meng from the Lee Kong Chian School of Medicine. Ng Tian Yang, Bachelor of Communication Studies. Wishes to honor Mrs. Seng Fan Po Yok from Ngee Ann Polytechnic. And Ms. Wong Pei Wen from the Wee Kim Wee School of Communication and Information. Ong Chin Hui, Bachelor of Engineering, Bioengineering. Wishes to honor Ms. Yim Ai Lin from River Valley High School. And Associate Professor Sirin Lim from the School of Chemical and Biomedical Engineering. Tan Wan Yen, Bachelor of Science in Biomedical Sciences, NTU Beijing University of Chinese Medicine Double Degree Program. Wishes to honor Ms. Lu Shu En from River Valley High School. And Dr. Chao Yen from the School of Biological Sciences. Ti Mei Yi, Bachelor of Engineering Science and Master of Science in Technology Management. Wishes to honor Dr. Charles Ong Ban Chun from Ngee Ann Polytechnic. And Professor Teo Sui Hin from the School of Chemical and Biomedical Engineering.
Mr. Chancellor, may I present the following graduates on whom the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Public Policy and Global Affairs has earlier been conferred. Winner of the Lee Kuan Yew Gold Medal, Pitt Wei Zhe. USP scholar Quek Lee Chun, Ariel Marie. USP scholar So Ming Lee. Ang Ying Chi, Crystal. Ariana Amaran. Uni Haizika Gufran. Celine Xie Xiujin. Chiu Xiu Ling, Ophelia. Chin Clara. Chu Yong Shun. Christine Lim Hui Ying. Chua Wan Zhen. Dania Rihanna Sahid. Adiasti Ahmad. Jermaine Lim Chien Hui. Gunnar Vartini Sigamani. Kairu Anwar Ahmad. Rahman, sorry. Lee Chien Corrine. Lee Xin Yi Jamina. Lee Zheng Dao. Liao Xiu Hui Joy. Lim Francine. Lim Ming Yi Vivian. Lim Rongqing Lydia. Lionel Fu. Long Xue E. Lo Chun Chuan. Lo Yi Hui. Nabila Rosli. Nadia Suhaimi. Ng Yen Zheng, Kesselin. Narani Muhammad Yasli. Nuru Akila Manash. Nuru Iman Muhammad Taib. Ong Min Lee. Ong Zhao Wei Jonathan. Pui Siying Rachel. Kwa Kai Zhi. Quek Ziqing Perlin. S. Durga Devi. Sasha Ong Lee Wen. Si Chong Ling Elizabeth. Yeah. Xi Xueqi Sylvain. Xiet Ingqi Clara. Sarianti Saril. Siti Nashafika Shak Aminor Rashid. Stephanie Lu Pei Ning. Tan Hui Ru Judy. Tan Jie En Rebecca. Tan Mavis. Tan Wei Xuan. Tay Li Jie. Tu Jia Hui. Tio Jia Hui. Tio Kang Sheng Kenneth. Tong Wei Jie. Sao Karen Kayan. Venus Go Qian Yi. Wang Hui Shan. Wang Li Yan. Wang Yun Xuan. Yi Han Ken. Yusfrahin Yusuf. Zhang Su Yi Suzy. The valedictorian, Mr. Seng Hui Min Kevin, will now give his speech.
That's okay. Chancellor, Nanyang Technological University, His Excellency President Tony Tan Keng Yam, Minister for Education, Higher Education and Skills, Mr. Ong Yi Kang, Pro-Chancellors, Chairman, NTU Board of Trustees, Mr. Koh Boon Hui, Members, NTU Board of Trustees, Excellencies, President NTU, President Emeritus, Honorary Doctorate Recipients, Distinguished Guests, Graduates and Family Members, Alumni and friends of the university, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning to all of you. I'm Kevin from the Renaissance Engineering Program, and I'm honored to be speaking on behalf of the class of 2017 today. We have all learned a lot over the past few years, and no doubt, the knowledge will be valuable as we move forward in life. But above all, one thing has struck me deeply, the value of teamwork. Let me share a story. During our 1 year overseas exchange in UC Berkeley, My REP classmates and I stayed in the student hostel called the International House, which houses, as the name implies, international students. We were given an opportunity to showcase Singapore, just one day to introduce Singapore. We spared no effort at it. We constructed a photo booth, complete with props of famous Singapore landmarks like the Esplanade and the ERP gantry. We let guests play traditional games such as chapteh and five stones. We prepared various local food such as laksa and indomie. We even had a Malay dance showcase. So how did we do all this? Days of planning and help from almost every Singaporean we could find. We even worked with the master students. I would love to thank everyone, but there are too many people and too little time. Nevertheless, kudos to our master chef Yuan Ming, dance choreographer Shazana, creative director Matthew, and everyone else who helped out. You know who you are. So what did this event teach me? Teamwork. Teamwork allows the whole to be greater than the sum of its parts. Each group focused on their own work. For instance, the culinary team prepared food and the creative team decorated the venue. And when all the fruits of our labor were put together in this one huge event, we, the Singaporeans, were able to provide visitors with an immersive experience of Singapore. They were amazed at the level of detail and cultural exposure provided. In fact, we were unofficially dubbed the best country showcase of that year. Take note, unofficially. You are welcome to confirm this with the International House staff yourself. And if I've already piqued your interest, you can YouTube it yourself by searching for, take note, Singapore Coffee Hour 2015. By the way, even the video was produced by our very own Lin. Unfortunately, as lunch is calling, I'm unable to show the video today. It's been a long journey, and finally, we are here in our graduation gowns. Nevertheless, we can all agree that such a journey could not have been undertaken without the help from those around us. So first, fellow graduates, look beside you and pat your friend on the shoulder for a job well done. I'll pat mine. Yeah. Okay. So next, on behalf of the class of 2017, I would like to thank all faculty members for their dedication to teaching and sharing their knowledge with us. Furthermore, let's also thank the administrative staff in all the faculty offices, for without their help, we probably couldn't even have matriculated. And finally, who can forget the unsung heroes who have been working silently in the background, ensuring that we do not have much to worry about back home? Class of 2017, let's stand up, turn around, and give a round of applause to our parents and loved ones to show our appreciation for their contributions all these years. Okay, please have a seat. So before I end my speech, let me leave you with an African proverb that I'm sure all of you are familiar with. If you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. No man's an island at the workplace. Work with your colleagues, and you'll be surprised at how much a team can accomplish. Okay, I won't hold you and your lunch back. Thank you for all your time and attention. I wish you all the best in our next journey. Have a great future ahead.
Thank you.
I declare this convocation closed.